maybe this is not the move. No, back down, back down. Hi guys, welcome back to the vlog and welcome to Vlogmas Day 21. Is that right? That doesn't feel right. And the tippy tappies are arriving. Gonna have to double check that because genuinely don't know what day it is. Also, gonna be honest, today was the closest that I have been to skipping a day. Oh my god, I was this close. I was this close. I woke up this morning with a massive headache and it's starting to feel better now. But I have just been so excited for the week between Christmas and New Year's where I can just be an absolute degenerate, guilt-free. But this morning has been like a busy morning for me, kind of like digitally on the internet. If you guys remember, I uploaded a skincare routine, a nighttime skincare routine, and I very clearly stated that it was not Hyrum approved. And Hyrum reacted to it today and it is hilarious. Honestly, I thought it was gonna be a roastier roast than it actually was because like I am aware of how bad makeup wipes are for just about everything. And honestly, he gave me some really great advice. So I'm looking forward to transitioning my Costco makeup wipes out of my skincare routine. So that was super exciting. I love Hyrum's channel. I am such a fan. So like was definitely massively fangirling. Also, I just uploaded the goodbye for now video on the main channel. Again, I know kind of a dramatic title. I mentioned this in the video, but I just didn't know how to properly word a title that accurately described that I just needed to take a break, take a breath, take a moment to recollect myself and figure out what the fuck I want to do on that channel because I genuinely don't know, but I will be back. See, like that doesn't really have the same ring to it in a title as goodbye for now. So I thought it was just like concise, a little bit of drama, and I guess a little accurate. So that has been my morning. Also, a package just arrived and I ordered earrings. Who am I? Literally, who am I? This is one of my favorite jewelry brands, Local Eclectic. Ooh, ooh, ooh. This is like buttery paper. Big fan. That was really nerdy that I just said that. I saw a similar pair of earrings on this like really cool fashion girl on TikTok and I immediately went and found something similar. I don't know if hers are from Local Eclectic, but oh my god, they're so cute. Again, we'll have to re-pierce my ears, but they are little tiny gold safety pins. I don't know if you can see that. Ooh, I'm such a beauty influencer. I'm such a beauty guru. And I guess they just go like this. I don't know. I haven't worn earrings in so long. You guys know that it's just like not a thing I normally do. I mentioned this earlier in Vlogmas, but I had my ears gauged to the point where I could stick a whole pencil through them. So I just feel like if I want to re-pierce my ears again, I feel like there's definitely still a little path in my earlobe. And we are gonna bank on that. Also, today is definitely a no makeup vlog, so apologies. In yesterday's vlog, I promised you guys that I would show you all of the season 2 Craftopia outfits. So transparently, season 1 of Craftopia, that's already on HBO Max now, had a massive styling budget. Like I think it was season 1, go hard with it, make an incredible show, wow everyone, get renewed for season 2. Season 2's styling budget was a fraction of season 1, but my stylist pulled off some incredible looks and you also approve 2 outfits per episode, so you have a backup basically. So 8 episodes total in season 2, and we had a ton of different options. Maybe this is not the move. No, back down, back down. I was trying to explain this in yesterday's vlog, and I didn't know the difference or understand any of this until I had a show. TV clothing is so much different than like regular life clothing, like the wearability of it and just like the way that things fit and the colors and what you can and cannot wear that like look good on camera are two separate worlds. So there are definitely a bunch of really cute pieces that are wearable in regular life now. Maybe not like quarantine life. Like I feel like there's just no world where I'd be wearing this sweater in quarantine just like hanging out. But there are so many fun pieces and I'll pop up photos just like on screen of pieces that I've already worn. Gonna be honest, still don't feel great. So not gonna do a try on portion. Love you, thank you for understanding. And let's rate some Craftopia season 2 outfits. Also, season 2 2 should be up in fall of 2021. So you're getting a real sneak peek right now. Didn't really ask for approval on this, but I'm sure it's fine. Okay, so this pink sweater I wore with jeans on one of the days and then some white pumps, and it was a vibe. It was a really, really cute like holiday vibe. The pumps were white and I kind of felt like Ariana Grande. This sweater also screams mom from Mean Girls to me, and I am living. Oh my god, I can see the foundation on like the inside of the little boa part. So cute though. This is from Zara. I'm gonna give her an 8.5. Next is this rust color jumpsuit. It was really cute and really flattering because it kind of comes in at the waist and then also tapers off at the bottom of the leg and kind of has like the cargo pants style with the pockets on the side. I feel like, can you, okay, yep. Here we go. And there's one whole leg. Oh god. I'm pretty sure this ended up being a backup because there is a similar colored dress in here that is absolutely stunning. Oh my god, it was one of my favorite pieces that I wore the entire season. I would say like a 7 out of 10, but like wearability wise now, more like a 5.5. But also like everything right now is a 0 out of 10 wearability because we're just at home right now. Oh, actually, I kind of take that back. Okay, this was a really cute black bodysuit, and I don't know if you can see the ruching detail, and there's also some underwire in the boobie, so it was a nice little lift. This is from the brand Babaton. This was actually super, super cute. We ended up pairing it with, I think it was these pants. Living my best Avril Lavigne life, to be honest. It was really cute though. I think we did a pair of heels with these. I can't entirely remember, but it was cute and it was like holiday chic. And also when you're surrounded by like the most incredible holiday themed set, like this doesn't feel that crazy, if that makes sense. And that's what I mean about holiday television. Like, would I wear these on a regular life basis? Like, no, 0 out of 10. But on TV, they were like a solid 8 out of 10. And this bodysuit I feel like is totally wearable, so we'll give her a 7 out of 10. Oh, this jumpsuit was, I wore this on the first day of filming. It was so cute. Okay, so super flattering because again, it cinches at the waist, has a full zipper that goes all the way. Where is this from? Oh, this is an Alice and Olivia jumpsuit. Alice and Olivia makes the best stuff. It's such good quality. And then the best part of this jumpsuit is that they had these super wide leg flare bottoms. You can see it. This is it. I'm doing a terrible job. Maybe we go this way again. Yeah, this is the move for the jumpsuits. So it was like this and this, and these were flared and wide leg, but it was so fitted at the top. And honestly, just like a solid first day of filming outfit because I felt like super confident, and it's black, so it was slimming. Overall, 10 out of 10 for TV and 10 out of 10 for real life. This next outfit was genuinely my favorite, and I was so sad because I got dressed in it and they decided that it was a little too sussy for camera. And I was heartbroken. It also meant that we had to reshoot a few things because we had like started filming and I was wearing it and they were like, a little too sassy. And I was like, no. So anyways, very excited that I get to keep the outfit because one of the tailors literally custom made and hand fabricated this entire shirt. Oh my god. Also, I'm like sweating and dying and so thirsty. Please hold. The sweater is off. We're serious now. Okay, so this is what it looks like. Also, this is so ugly and ruining everything. Goodbye. So it's like this cream sheer long sleeve boat neck top. I don't even know. It's so sheer with all these little pearls on it. Oh my god. It's so pretty. And it went over top of this bodysuit and it was so pretty. And then this bottom portion was covered by this other cream skirt. Like, I don't know if you can see how pretty this outfit was, but it was stunning. It was the biggest Craftopia heartbreak that I had for sure the entire season. Ooh, next, we definitely did not end up wearing this shirt, but it's like this really interesting cropped dress shirt, but also had ties. Like super, super long ties. You could kind of crisscross it around your body. I don't know if this had a bottom planned for it, but I know we had this picked out and it was approved, etc. Also, I'm looking at the price tag right now. $410. Cool, cool, cool. For like half a shirt. This next one, I can't remember if I wore or not, but it was this really cute sweater dress. And I think originally it was just a long cardigan, but then the tailor was able to add some like hook and eyelet clasp so that it could do up and be really cute and just like a little wrap sweater dress. Again, very holiday and like grandma chic. Probably not wearable again in real, maybe it is. Television, I'd give her like a 6.5 out of 10. Real life, maybe less. Maybe a 5 out of 10. We forgot to rate our overpriced Britney Spears Hit Me Baby One More Time tie up intermix shirt. So expensive. Maybe 5 out of 10. This next set was so cute. I didn't end up wearing it because it was like very, very tight. And when you're on set for 16 hours, you eat like 4 meals, a lot of coffee, a lot of beverages, staying hydrated, and naturally your body expands. So it was not an outfit that I would have been comfortable in for the entire day. I would have died. I basically would have died is what I'm saying. So this was the top and it was like off the shoulder. It was very, very cute. And then the bottoms were a high-waisted matching color. Also, like, whose waist fits in this? Not mine. Not mine. Let me be very clear. So it was a high-waisted and then just like super wide leg pants. But when you had heels on, the little peep of the stiletto was very, very cute. So TV, like 8.5 out of 10. Real life, 4 out of 10. Like, we'll never wear this. We'll never have anywhere to wear this. But it looks so good on camera. But also, like, can't eat and also wear clothing with this waist size. Oh my God, seriously, it is so cool that you get to keep all of this stuff, like very blessed and lucky, but oh my God. Oh, I see my favorite pair of jeans. I see my favorite pair of jeans. I have been dying for our like wardrobe to get released so that I can start wearing these jeans again because they are so comfy. And you guys know that I don't f with jeans. You know that about me. I can't remember if I ended up wearing this pair of, I don't even know if it's considered denim, but they are from the brand Derek Lamb 10 Crosby and they're super cute. So it's kind of like a tapered bottom cargo pant and it feels like denim, but it's a little more blue. Oh no, we did wear this. We did wear this. It's coming back. And it was paired with this amazing like silk corset bodysuit, which was so pretty. So it was this and then this, and it was so, so stunning on camera. I feel like 10 out of 10 for on camera and like 9 out of 10 for real life. Like, this could definitely be worn again. These bottoms were a little bit less wearable for real life, so I don't normally wear anything that's got like a tie around the waist, but they are super cute and fit really well. Also, the mountain of clothing next to me that I don't know what I'm gonna do with after we finish filming this, not entirely sure. Oh my God, these jeans, Allison Olivia jeans, I wonder if there's like a tag or a serial number, because these are hands down the comfiest jeans that I have ever worn in my entire life. They have the stretch and the comfort of a really, really thick legging and like, dare I say, jegging. But it's the thickness of regular jeans, it's the texture of regular jeans while still being like buttery, and they don't lose shape or stretch out, which I feel like is a super common issue with any kind of stretchy denim, is by the end of the day, the waist of the jeans is just like 2 inches stretched out more than it originally was. So highly recommend. It also had this cute little cutout at the bottom here. 10 out of 10 for TV, 10 out of 10 for real life. Oh my God. Okay, so this is the copper dress. I'm gonna have to put photos on screen because it's just gonna look like a bunch of hanging fabric when it's on a hanger. But again, it's like that really nice copper rust color. It had some ruche detailing down the side and it was stunning. So this is the outfit that we took all of the main photos in. So I'm hoping, praying, fingers crossed, that the photos from this day and this outfit will be like the main season 2 photos, because like the hair was on point. The stilettos that went with this, they might even be in the box, had like butterflies on them. I had butterflies in my hair. 3 packs of extensions and like it is a look. Oh my God. So TBD on when we'll find out about that. But oh my God, 10 out of 10 for TV. And then maybe like 5 out of 10 for regular life. Ooh, okay, this next one, I definitely have a photo of me wearing this. Oh my God, was I wearing Shackets before Shackets blew up in the last couple months? I think I may have been. It's this really pretty green and white, kind of like tweed. And it had a rough edge at the bottom here, which was so cute. We had a gold belt around the waist to like cinch it and give it shape. And then, oh my God, wait till you see the boots that I was wearing this. I think I posted the boots on social media because they were so insane. Genuinely, I don't know what I'm gonna do with these. now that I have them in my possession. So there is a clear stiletto inside of it. So yes, your foot gets so sweaty. You can see like the condensation of like your life happening in the shoe, which is very disgusting. It's really only when you look really close up. And then this is just like a crystal mesh. So it's just on your skin and it's got an elastic top here. So it hugs your leg. Oh my God, these were absolutely stunning. They were so high and so uncomfortable. I wanted to die, but they looked incredible. Another perfect example of like 10 out of 10 for TV, maybe like 4 out of 10 for regular life. I'm not gonna say that I won't ever wear these again, potentially for a photo shoot, because oh my God, stunning. Also, is anyone a little bit worried about their entire closet just like not even being in style again once we can go back out into the world? I just feel like fashion is like still changing and we still haven't gone out into the world, and I'm a little worried that half my closet is not gonna be in style by time we start living again. Also, rating for our little tweed holiday number here, I would say 8 out of 10 for on TV, on screen. And then definitely less wearable in regular life, maybe like a 4 out of 10. I also never wear green, like ever, 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 ever. And the stylist convinced me to do this little number. So glad she did. It looked great on camera, especially with the boots. I had good hair that day. Oh my God. These were the butterfly shoes of actual death that went with that rust colored dress. They are so mangled now because obviously I wore them for like 16 hours for the day that I was actually wearing the outfit. So we've got butterflies missing from so many different areas, but they were so cool. I feel like for a craft show, there's just so many opportunities to do literal DIYs in the outfits and make it just like a little more fun and elevated and creative. And this was a prime example of like some of the little nods at DIY that we were able to incorporate in the outfits. Died, just like actually died. This is a straight incline and I died. I just feel like my ankles are not made for this steepness. I'm really not good with this. And then our last pair of shoes, I ended up wearing a ton of my own shoes because I have a pair of pumps from, I want to say Steve Madden, but I don't think it is. Anyways, I have a pair of pumps that fit really well and I know my exact size. So I ordered them in gold, white, black, and nude. We incorporated those in a few of the outfits. I got to wear some Jordans in a few of the outfits. And then I think there were a pair of knee-high boots that I also wore that were my own. But anyways, these boots are so fun and so cute. A faux red snakeskin with a chunky like square heel, so cute. Probably will not be wearing for a very long time because I feel like heels are not in my near future. So that probably means that red snakeskin heels are even further down the timeline in my lifetime. But a solid like 8.5 out of 10 for TV, and then I would say 8 for regular life as well. Okay, I think that is everything. I have no idea what I'm gonna do with most of this. Like a few of these pieces will obviously get absorbed into my closet, but the other pieces, I'm like, what am I gonna do with you? Anyways, headache again is like fading away a little bit more and more, and my coffee delivery just got here, so caffeine has arrived. I'm good. It's about to get dark, but I am feeling much better. Healthy eating starts in 2021, baby. There's just nights where you crave Maggiano's and noodles or pasta, and that was one of those nights. I've got the bread.
Support local businesses.
Support local businesses.
Buying from a national chain.
Jeremy got lasagna, and then I may or may not have gotten gnocchi for tomorrow. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Hello, this is not my angle whatsoever. It's the sweater covering my double chin right now. So we'll just tuck this in. I look like an absolute egg, I'm aware. I have regrets. How many times will I eat a dairy heavy pasta dish and feel like shit afterwards and not learn my lesson? The limit does not exist. That's the answer to that question. I feel heavy and bloated and uncomfortable. Uncomfortably full is like the right way to describe it. So that's where we're at right now. Okay, that's it for my check-in. Goodbye.
Bubbies, what time is it?
Sorry for the not so versatile vlog of clips today. I like kind of felt like a little Christmas sad today. So I wanted to do the haul for you guys. I know I promised to do the Craftopia season 2 outfits haul. So I wanted to make sure we did that. But honestly, today, just like, I wasn't feeling it. I wasn't feeling it, Snoog. Did a ton of cleaning and organizing though, because that massive box came and then I hauled it. There was a literal explosion of clothing on the dining room table. So took care of that and broke down a ton of boxes. And now for the highlight of the day, Snoog. I feel like we had a major missed opportunity of not having some kind of advent calendar treat song. Okay, so confirmed, it's day 20 of Vlogmas. This is the only way I know where I am in the world. Oh no. Oh, there's, wait, there's 2 days in this one. You're definitely not eating all of these. Sir, sir, sir. Okay, I'm gonna put one of these back in because I feel like a day must have shifted and slid over into day 20. Okay, we'll just leave that there in case maybe tomorrow. Day 21 is right next door to it, so maybe day 21 got shifted. Okay, we're on the diet version of the advent calendar now, which means that you get two little pieces. Can I have this pop? Thank you so much, Mr. Moose. Gentle. Wait, wait, wait. Gentle. That was pretty gentle. His chair though is like not very stable and it's rocking back and forth so hardcore. We've got a new hand technique here. Easy, easy. That was pretty gentle. There's no little piece. We missed a little piece at the end and that was just strictly my finger. Was it delicious, bubby? All right, guys, I am going to end Vlogmas day 20 here. Tomorrow is Monday, day 21. So we've got, what, like 4 more videos after this one? Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed today's vlog and I will see you tomorrow for Vlogmas day 21. Okay, bye guys, love you.